Hello. Okay, so let's begin. Good morning. Does 11th lord in 11th house guarantee wealth? It depends on the planet also. Okay, but we can say it guarantees wealth depending upon the nature of the planet. Okay, what I mean to say is that suppose Saturn is 11th lord and it is sitting in the 11th house. Now Saturn is a malefic planet. It represents delays, hard work, perseverance and all. So here also, like Saturn in 11th house in Capricorn or Aquarius can give wealth to the person, but with the Saturnian nature, delay, hard work and perseverance. Person would have to show perseverance, do put his best of effort. And then with certain delay in life, he will gain wealth. So that is the thing. We can say that 11th lord in 11th house is good for wealth related matters, money related matters, but as per the nature of the planet. Okay, Saturn can make a delay, Venus can bring easy wealth, okay, easy money. Jupiter again is a benefic planet. If it is in good dignity, it can bring easy money. Another example is like sun in the 11th house can, in Leo can bring money from authority, from any authoritative position. Okay, so this is what I mean to say. Plus, it also means that where what type of activities you are doing, okay, like with Jupiter. Jupiter is all about knowledge sharing. So, if Jupiter is in Sagittarius or in Pisces, person will have wealth coming only by knowledge sharing. Best wealth is coming from best wealth is coming from knowledge sharing. The person has to go through the activities of knowledge sharing, then only he can expect good wealth. So these clauses are there, these conditions are there, then we can say that 11th lord in 11th house guarantees wealth. There is nothing like guarantee without any effort. I hope everyone understands this. Thanks sir to come in the daytime. Yes, I have a consultation in evening, so that's why we are having this session in the daytime. Otherwise we would have these sessions in the evening time only. Okay, Jupiter fifth lord in Magha, which hobbies suits best? Anything related with knowledge sharing. Jupiter, knowledge sharing, fifth lord in Magha. Magha is about your ancestors also. Magha is also about royalness and all. Okay, yeah, because it represents royal throne. It is represented by royal throne. So that is the thing. Then Magha is, as I said, it is related with Pitris and all. So Jupiter can make a person like this person can get lot of education knowledge around ancestors or ancient things. Okay, they may like to read about history. Okay, what happened in the ancient past, it may be an interest for them when Jupiter is in Magha. Plus as it is ruled by Ketu, Magha is ruled by Ketu, the obvious or normal interest in the occult can be there. Okay, they can be interested in occult and research oriented matters when Jupiter is in Magha Nakshatra. But it is very good for authority. Okay, understand this thing. Magha is the nakshatra of royal authority. Jupiter expands things, so it can expand someone's authority. How to judge a planet if in a good sign but bad nakshatra? Is nakshatra more important than the sign? Dignity we see only through the sign. Okay, we decide the dignity of a planet as per the sign. If planet is in good dignity as per the sign, then sooner or later it will give some results. Okay, if it is in difficult nakshatra, okay, let's take this example. Kritika Arun and Vrksha. I'm just checking the signs and nakshatra where. Okay, so if we take the example of Mars is in Capricorn. Okay, Mars is in Capricorn. It can be in three different nakshatras: Uttarashada, Shravana, and Dhanishta. Mars gets exactly exalted in Dhanishta. Okay, let's say Mars is in Dhanishta but in Aquarius sign. Dhanishta spreads over Aquarius sign also. So Mars is in Aquarius but in Dhanishta nakshatra, where it gets exalted in Capricorn. So for Dhanishta related results, Mars can still give good results. Okay, but for house where Aquarius falls and for Aquarius related results, person can still have frustrations. Okay, this is where I'm trying to make the distinction. Jupiter in Leo in Purva Falguni. This is better example. Jupiter in Leo in Purva Falguni. Leo is friendly sign for Jupiter. It is good dignity. But Purva Falguni is nakshatra of enemy. It is ruled by Venus. Jupiter and Venus are enemies to each other. So in Purva Falguni related matters, person can still feel frustrated. Okay, when Jupiter is in Purva Falguni, he will get result, but he will frustrated. He will feel frustrated out of it. Okay, I should have got more results. I got minimum results. I didn't get as much as I desired or as much as I worked for, that kind of stuff. But when it comes to overall Leo related thing or the house where Leo falls in the chart, Jupiter can give good results related with that house. Okay, another distinction we can always make is between Jiva Karaka, Ajiva Karaka, living significances, non-living significances. Living significances are like your relationship and all, and non-living significances are like your non-relationship results, like your real estate, your car, your vehicle, your AC, fridge, all these things. So when planet is in average dignity, like this kind of thing, that it is in friendly sign but in enemy nakshatra, or friendly nakshatra and enemy sign, these combination can give you better results in non-living significances. Problems can come up in living significances. Problem can come up in your relationship matters, but when it comes to your non-living results, your your money related result, your finance, vehicles, home, real estate, all these results will still give you the good results. Okay. Virgo ascendant Jupiter in second house Swati Nakshatra, is it a Dhani Yoga? Dhani Yoga, I will tell you what it is. Whenever first lord, first, second, fifth, eighth, ninth, and 11th. Okay. First, okay, I understand. First, second, fifth, eighth, ninth, and 11th. These houses, lords, are exchanging positions. Then it is called Dhani Yoga. Okay, these are the houses of giving you money. So there any combination between these houses, okay, or house lords is like you are having possibilities of gaining wealth. Possibilities of gaining wealth is in every chart. It is not that if someone doesn't have a Dhani Yoga, he cannot make money. He can make money. Still he has second house, still he has 11th house, still he has 8th house, and still he has planets like Jupiter and Venus in his chart. So if he acts in a right way, if his actions are in right direction, sooner or later he will have money. So this is not that okay, fine, one person must have Dhan Yoga, then only he will become rich, nothing like that. If you are putting your efforts in right direction, you sooner or later you will have money. What will be the result of five planets conjunction in first house of Aries Navamsha and Mars is exalted? Again, as I always say, I prefer looking at D1 chart first. So I may not be able to fully help you in this matter, but all I can say is that Navamsha chart is the chart of your right life path. When so many planets are sitting in the first house of self in D9 chart, it shows that while following right life path, this person should work for himself. This is what this conjunction shows, that he should focus on himself rather than like serving others, rather than getting into job setup and all. He should focus on himself. Today is my birthday. Happy birthday, sir. Everyone, please say happy birthday to Three Vikram Acharyaji. Happy birthday and have a great year ahead. My good wishes are with you always. And with everyone else. Okay. So enjoy your day. Which planet does Rahu best set with best conjunction position? Whenever it is with exalted planets, Rahu and Ketu give best result when they are with exalted planets, like Rahu with Moon exalted in Taurus. Okay, Rahu with Mercury exalted in Virgo, Ketu with Mercury exalted in Virgo. They should be with if anyone wants best results of Rahu and Ketu, they should always be with exalted planets. Okay, so that's where the best results come. Okay. Even then, like in that case, when we have to take up the basic nature of the planets, like Rahu with Saturn in Libra, Rahu with exalted Saturn will still give you some troubles because Saturn itself is troubles. Okay, so it is not that you will not face any trouble if Rahu is with some exalted planet. A malefic planet is supposed to bring some trouble. It is their nature. Okay, understand. Malefic planets are like villains of our movie. Villain's job is to create obstacle in the path of the hero, so that hero overpowers those obstacles and we realize the importance of the hero. Likewise, a malefic planet creates obstacles in our life so that we can overpower those obstacles and we can realize our true potential. Okay, this is the job of malefic planet. So in any case, a malefic planet is supposed to bring some difficulties. They themselves represents difficulty. Always understand it like this. Just like Venus itself represents wealth. Venus is wealth. Okay, wherever Venus is sitting in chart, it is bringing wealth from that house. Likewise, a malefic planet like Saturn, Rahu, they themselves represent difficulties. So in any case, they will bring some difficulty. Okay, if Saturn is yoga karak, can we then rely on Saturn? You can always rely on Saturn. Okay, what is the difficulty in relying? So let me know on what points you want to rely upon Saturn. Okay, for what reasons do you want to rely on Saturn, then I can help you. So if you think that this Saturn is yoga karak and it can give you all the good results and all that, and it may not represent any difficulty or misery, then nothing like that. Saturn in itself is misery. As I was saying, malefic planets themselves represent difficulties. Now, wherever they are going, they are representing difficulty. So even if Saturn is yoga karak, then it is then also it is difficulties. It is difficulty related with those houses. Again, it will give a result with delay, hard work and perseverance. With malefic planet, it doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter if they are exalted, debilitated and all. Nothing. Especially with Saturn, it never matters. Saturn is always troublesome. Saturn in Libra. Libra is the sign of relationship. Most biggest relationship conflicts or challenges people have when they have Saturn in Libra. Okay. So understand. Always understand Saturn through few. I can give another example how to understand Saturn. Okay. Look at the mythology story of Saturn. Okay. If you look at the mythology story of Saturn or Shani, you will realize one thing, that first of all, his mother left him, Sandhya. His stepmother Chaya never loved him. His father discarded him. His siblings never respected him. Okay. All he got in his life was misery. All Saturn got in his life was misery. You can give to others what you have. I can give this little bit of knowledge of astrology because I know a little bit of astrology. You can serve people in your trade because you know something about that trade. This person, this guy, Saturn, got only misery from other people. So all he can serve to us is misery. That's it. So in any case, in any house, in any sign, it represents misery. It doesn't matter whether it is exalted, debilitated, it is yoga karak, it is Vargottama, it is in the first house, it is ascendant lord. Nothing, no theory applies with Saturn. None of these theories will ever apply on the Saturn. Saturn is difficulty because it itself is difficulty. Wherever Saturn is going, it is bringing that difficulty in that house. Okay, it can be bad or worse, but it can never be good. Okay, now if you want to know where Saturn can be good, okay, there is one exception where Saturn is good. Understand, Saturn gives the results in long durations. Okay, it will make you work hard for like 5-10 years and then you will get the result. Only good thing is that when it gives the result, even those results are for long term. those results are going to stay for lifelong, many a times lifelong with you, or many a times even beyond life, like your next generations can also be benefited from those results. Okay, like if you create a business, okay, suppose you create a business, you worked hard for 10 years on that business and you started getting recognition out of that business and people started knowing you. Now this recognition, now this success of business will remain there as long as you are there, as long as that business is there. And even if you pass away, your next generation will be benefited from that recognition. So this is Saturn working. This we can see in every celebrity person's life. Every person who is little bit known, that they worked hard initially for their success, but when they got success, that success remained with them, and then not only for them but their next generations got benefited one after the other. This is how Saturn, we can say Saturn is benefic in a way. First it will make you work hard. Okay, first it will like make you work hard like anything, and will ask for perseverance. And then when it gives, it gets the hard work and perseverance, then whatever results it gives for your lifetime. Okay, so this is the only way where we can say that okay, Saturn is like good, because whatever results come, they remain for lifelong. Okay. So that is the thing. Otherwise, Saturn is the most malefic planet. It doesn't matter. It is a Yoga Karak, it is Ascendant Lord, it is Vargottama, anything. Nothing like. What is your take on Mangal in Karak, especially on July 4th, when it will exactly oppose Shani? I wrote an article on Mars transit in Cancer. It is debilitated, it is difficult energy. That article will help you. Just search, you will get on the site itself in the recent article section. I recently wrote it, okay. So you will get it. But if I just explain it here, then Mars in Cancer is difficult because it is debilitated, plus it is aspecting Saturn. It can be a really stressful time for government, okay. Understand one thing, that Capricorn is the sign of government, Saturn is the law and order. Saturn in Capricorn is already putting lots of pressure on governments, world governments, due to this COVID thing and all. And now Mars, debilitated Mars is also aspecting Saturn. This is stressful, like Mars-Saturn combination in birth chart, or Mars-Saturn mutual aspect in even in transit or birth chart, it is difficult. Okay, it can create lots of stressful circumstances. Mars in Cancer represents accidents, sudden events also, so we need to be careful regarding that also. But overall, it can be a stressful transit for government. Okay, they can be under fire. Or any person who is an authority figure, any person who is authority in his own field. We relate authority with government or government officers and all, but it is nothing like that. It is just that if you are authority in your own field, like Sachin Tendulkar is authority in cricket, Amitabh Bachchan is authority in acting, so Lata Mangeshkar is authority in singing. So this transit where Mars is in Cancer and it is aspecting Saturn in Capricorn, this transit can be difficult for authoritative figures, people who are in position of authority. Okay, all right. So if Rahu is with Yoga Karak planet, example Venus in Capricorn ascendant, it depends on Yoga Karak planet is there, but what is the dignity of Venus? That is important. If Rahu, Venus is in good dignity, we can expect better results, especially like Rahu Venus conjunction is good for financial matters. It can make someone really rich, but at the same time this person will find it difficult to like save money. Okay, so Rahu Venus conjunction can bring that. In relationship matters, it is difficult, it can cause some some illusion, some cheating in relationship and all. But for financial matters, it is good. But if Venus is not in good dignity, then it can be like troublesome thing that that person is like making money, but he is not able to save the money. Okay, or he is making money through wrong means. Okay, means are not correct. That is the kind of result we can get. Okay, so it largely depends upon the dignity again. Saturn is my Atma Karaka. Difficulty ka definition I want to write. You can write. So Saturn is difficulty. Saturn is equal to difficulty. Jupiter and Moon in Lagna, Cancer Lagna, Venus in Libra, financial situation in Venus Mahadasha. Venus rules your 11th house and 4th house sits into the 4th house, and it is also most benefic planet money wise. In money matters, it is the most benefic planet. 4th house is home. Libra is the sign of business. Get into your home or private office based business, then you will get better results. As I always say, any dasha can give us the better results or good results if we are doing something related with that planet, okay, or that planetary position. So Venus is in fourth house of home, Libra sign of business. Get into home based business or private office based business, you will get better results of Venus. If you are not doing anything like this, then average result. Okay, good morning sir, good morning. Okay, if Aries ascendant at 16 degrees rising, okay, Mars in third house at 9 degree, Moon in Cancer at 27 degree, Venus, Saturn, Ketu in fifth house, all in Magha Nakshatra, Sun in Virgo in Hasta Nakshatra, sixth house, Mercury in seventh house, Venus Mahadasha started in June 2018. At the age of 11 years, is there any yoga to be a doctor in this Kundali? As I always say, career consultation takes a long time. It is an analysis of around at least half an hour to 1 hour. So I cannot give whole of 1 hour here. Plus other factors are also there, like Atma Karaka, Matya Karaka, Dasha, and Bhrigu Bindu, which we need to see. Anyways, from this chart, we can see 6th house, Sun in Hasta, Mars in 3rd house at 9 degree, Gemini 9 degree, Nakshira, Ardhra, Moon in Cancer, Ashlesha. This person can be in medical field because he has some planets in those nakshatra which are medical oriented nakshatra. First of all, ascendant degree is Bharani. Bharani is the nakshatra of death and rebirth. Okay, because its deity is Lord Yama. Then Mars is in Ardhara nakshatra. Then Moon is in Ashlesha nakshatra. Venus, Saturn, Ketu are together in 5th house in Magha Nakshatra, which shows the authority coming. Sun in Virgo in Hasta, this is prominent. Hasta is healing and healthcare. Virgo represents the same. 6th house represents the same. Sun is sitting there. It is showing that someone is behind. Sun is the 5th lord going into the 6th house. It shows that someone can take education and guide, counsel people in healing and healthcare. Mercury in the 7th house, Venus Mahadasha started. So this kid should take education in this healing and healthcare, like medical side. If at all he gets interested in psychology, then it can be very good. Moon is in Ashlesha Nakshatra. Ashlesha is the Nakshatra of psychology. So this chart is good for medical side of career, especially psychology. But if if at all he has interest in. I am not pushing this. From this much information, I am just getting this idea. Okay, I don't mean to push him towards psychology. I am just saying that if at all he gets this inclination towards psychology, then it is also a good option. How planets will react during Mahadasha, where their degree is between 0 to 1 degree, like Jupiter in the 6th house of Lagna chart and Saturn, Rahu Ketu in 27 to 29 degree in Mahadasha. As I said before also, like planet in early degrees are like, always try to understand planets as people, as you and I, persons. Okay, planet in very early degrees from 0 to 5 degree are like those children who are at a very early age in their life. They have lots of energy, they can run around whole day, they can jump here and there, but they have no direction in their life. Okay, they have lots of energy to exhaust, but that energy is not directed in such in a particular way. So these planets which are in very early degree in your charts, they need some directions. Okay, they need some directions from planets of higher degree. Understand, planets at higher degree are like grandfather or great grandfathers in our family. They have the wisdom, they don't have the energy now, they have the wisdom, they can guide the children, right, what to do, what not to do. Likewise, planet in the higher degrees, that's why they become Atmakarka and Amatyakarka. They give the direction, and planet in the lower degrees put the energy, okay, in that direction. This is how we should understand it. So planet in the lower degrees, like Jupiter in 6th house of Lagna chart, it may have lots of energy, but it may not have the proper direction. So we need to find the right direction to redirect this energy. What should we look at to understand husband's success? 7th house, 7th house lord, this Venus or Jupiter. 7th house is your partner, okay, and your success, okay, understand, your success or recognition is your 10th house. So your partner's success or recognition will be your 4th house. 4th house is 10th from the 7th. So look at the 4th house, 4th house lord. That will suggest what type of success your partner can have in life or career. Okay. I am Leo ascendant. Lagnesh is conjunct with Mars. Okay. In 8th house, fine, Pisces. Moon Venus conjunct in 9th house Aries, Saturn in the 3rd house Libra, Jupiter in 4th house Scorpio, Ketu in the 5th house Sagittarius, the Mercury in 7th house, and Rahu in 11th house. I am currently running through Moon Mahadasha, Ketu Antardasha. Please explain what I am supposed to explain. Where is the question? Please ask your question, then I can tell you. Okay, because all these planetary placements can have thousands of meanings. What is your concern right now? This I always request people, that along with their question, they should send their along with their planetary details, they should tell you their questions, because then it is very difficult. My concern is about Mahadasha and Antardasha. You are under Moon Mahadasha and Ketu Antardasha. Moon is your 4th lord and sitting in ninth house, Sagittarius. During this Mahadasha, you should focus on your higher education, any type of learning, guiding, counseling, sharing your knowledge with others. That's where you will get the best of the result of this Mahadasha, because Moon is with Venus in the ninth house, Sagittarius. It is all about higher education. Okay. Ketu Antardasha. Ketu is sitting in your fifth house. Fifth house is the house of again education. It is Leo Lagna, so it will be in Aries. Moon, Venus are in Aries, and Ketu is in Sagittarius. So again, it is about for educational matters. This dasha is very good. Okay, Moon Ketu dasha. They both are indicating towards education and higher education. Okay. Where it can be troublesome, where when you are not focusing on your education and higher education, then it can be troublesome. Plus, Ketu represents separation, so in this dasha can bring some separation, can bring some events where you may have to let go of something or let go of someone. Okay, and if you are not ready to let go, then it can be a painful time period. But if you are ready to let go, then it can be a, okay, fine, you just sail through the dasha. Okay, so what I am trying to say, that it can be a time period where you may have to leave something, like suppose you are in relationship and Ketu is in the fifth house, in transit it is about to come into your seventh house, you may have a breakup kind of thing. I don't wish so, but it, I am just saying that it can come up. The circumstances may be difficult in your relationship, and you may have to break up. Now, if you are clinging on to the person, then you may feel that, okay, Ketu Dasha is very painful, okay, because I am going through this painful breakup and I am not able to let go of the person and all. But if you are ready to let go, if you are ready to accept that people come and go in life, there is no big deal. There is no one who is always going to stay in your life, and you are not going to stay in everyone's life forever. So if you accept that fact, then you can easily sail through this dasha. Okay. So this is where Ketu dasha can be good and bad both. If you are able to let go or leave something, then it is good. If you are not able to let go, then it is bad. Okay, plus Moon is mind, Ketu is meditation. Get into meditation, then it can be a better dasha. Thank you for your insights. You're welcome. Thank you. Welcome, sir. My concern is about Mahadasha Antardasha. I got it. Does Aquarius and Scorpio ascendant have karmic debt? We all have karmic debt, madam. We are here in this life them because of karmic debt only. Okay. It is not that these two signs only have karmic debt. They all have, we all have karmic debt. I understand from where this theory is coming, that Aquarius is co-ruled by Rahu and Scorpio is co-ruled by Ketu. But understand, Aquarius and Scorpio are there in your chart somewhere. Okay, for a Leo ascendant person, Scorpio is in the 4th house, Aquarius is in the 7th house. So they have their karmic debt towards their mother and the partner. For a Aquarius ascendant person, Aquarius is in the 1st house and Scorpio falls into the 10th house. So they have karmic debt towards their father. For a Virgo ascendant person, Scorpio falls into the 3rd house. So they have karmic debt towards their younger sibling. So we have karmic debts everywhere. Every person, if we are here in this world and we are living this life, it is because of our karmic debt. Otherwise, there was no reason to be here. Okay, that is the thing. I am truly happy in today's session. I ask myself every day in this Atma Karaka, Saturn is giving me things to do. Whether have much results. Happy to know that it gives function in next life also. I didn't say next life. I said that after your life, your next generation will be benefited. I didn't say it will give you result in your next life. Okay. Let's clarify this. I just said that if I put my best effort and I start getting the result, those results are going to remain with me throughout life, and if I pass away, my next generations will be benefited from those results. It is not that I will be benefited in next life. I don't know about next life. I don't know about this life also. Okay. So if Mercury is in Mrityu Bhaga, in 9th house, 10th house, I don't know much about all these things, Mrityu Bhaga and all. Okay. And the Lord of 2nd house, 3rd, and of 5th house, 6th. Could it be the reason for problems in family life and with education, children? First of all, everyone has problems in family life. There is no person who is not having problem in family life. So Mrityu Bhaga or not, relationship is always difficult. Family life is always difficult, or any relationship is always difficult, like with your children, with your partner, with your parents. I cannot say that I never had any conflict with my parents, right? So every relationship has its difficulty. It doesn't mean that look at now to validate this point, just look at those people's chart who don't have this type of placement or in Mrityu Bhaga, and let's see how is their relationship life. Okay. So relationship life or family life is always difficult for everyone. It is problematic. Please explain the combination of Akhanda Samrajya Yoga. I have heard many astrologers telling this yoga having little variations in combinations. I don't remember the actual combination. For some ascendants it makes, I think for all the fixed signs, fixed signs ascendant, and there is a combination which makes this Akhanda Samrajya Yoga. But again, the person should go through the dasha of the planet which is making this Akhanda Samrajya Yoga, and person should also be in position. Okay, what I am trying to say, best example is that Narendra Modi has this Akhanda Samrajya Yoga. Okay. And one of my friend also has Akhanda Samrajya Yoga. Okay, this is what I am trying to say. The exact same yoga is in her chart, but she is housewife. She cannot go into politics in her family. So this is where the difficulty comes in getting the results of yoga. That someone's social conditions are permitting him to follow the possibilities of yoga, someone else's social conditions are not permitting him. So this is where the difficulty comes. So this Akhanda Samrajya Yoga only means is that once this person gets the authority, that authority remains lifelong, something like that. But again, it depends on the dasha which you are going through, plus it also depends on the person's ability to utilize that dasha or time period. Okay, he should be in that condition. So just refer to Narendra Modi's chart and you will get this combination. Okay, looking great, thank you. You too. My next generation getting benefits is even better, right? I get scared always if my son will if my son will not meditate or do philanthropy later in life, that will be a pain for me. Happy if my Saturn Atmakarka gives him good karma. Strange Shani is my son's Amatkarka in the same Nakshatra Revati, Saturn Revati in D9. Right, so this is the thing that as we discuss, it can give good results for the next generation, but again their own efforts are also important. Okay, my एंड एक्स जनरेशन कैन बी बेनिफिटेड थ्रू माई एफर्ट्स लिटिल बिट बट इन द एंड दे वुड ऑल्सो हैव टू पुट द बेस्ट ऑफ द एफर्ट फॉर देयर ओन लाइफ. आई विल जस्ट रीड द कॉम्बिनेशन फॉर अखंड साम्राज्य होगा. जस्ट अ सेकेंड, आई डोंट रिमेंबर ऑल दीज योगास. यस, सो अखंड साम्राज्य होगा इज हाईली फॉर्चुनेट योगा. It is mandatory. The definition itself is like heavy little bit. Akhand Samrajya Yoga is caused when a strong Jupiter owning the 2nd, 5th and the 11th house from the Lagna and simultaneously one of the lords of the 11th, 9th or 2nd house occupies a Kendra, Kendra from the moon. Right. Thus, there are a strong Jupiter. Okay. Right. So, first of all, these four ascendants should be there. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. These four ascendants are required for Akhand Samrajya Yoga. Only these ascendants will make Akhand Samrajya Yoga. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Then, Jupiter should be strong placed. Strongly placed means either it is exalted on a own sign or friendly sign. This is the strong dignity of any planet. Then it should be the lord of either 2nd house, 5th house or 11th house. So for these ascendant it is the case that Jupiter is lord of these houses and it is strongly, if it is strongly placed in some sign, one sign, then 11th, the one of the lords of the 11th, 9th or 2nd occupies a Kendra from the moon. 11th lord or 9th lord or 2nd second lord is occupying Kendra house from the moon. From the moon it should be in the Kendra house. Then it causes this Akhand Samrajya Yoga. The definition itself is like little confusing. The result is that once this person gets the authority and then he is like having that authority lifelong. Okay, so if I just go again, first of all, fixed sign ascendant, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, fine. Then Jupiter should be strongly placed. Okay, Jupiter is the lord of these houses, 2nd, 5th and 11th. So these four ascendants, Jupiter should be strongly placed. And then your 11th lord, 2nd lord or 9th lord should be Kendra from the moon. Then it causes the Akhand Samrajya Yoga. Simple. Okay, so this is the thing. Cats are represented by Rahu. Ketu, dogs are represented by Ketu. If someone have pets in home, how we can associate it with our Rahu or Ketu? You associated them. Cats are Rahu and dogs are Ketu. If someone has pets in home, how we can associate? I am not getting the question because If someone has Rahu in the fourth house or fourth house from the moon, maybe then they may be more interested towards having cats rather than dogs. Okay, and that is the thing. So, plus it is also cultural thing. What I have realized over a period of time, like in Western societies, they have this cats more. In Eastern world, we prefer having dogs more in the as a pet animal, right? So it depends on different societies also, different cultures. They prefer different types of pet animals. Okay. Jupiter is not favorable for a Taurus ascendant. Why? What are its bad qualities? It is 8th lord, that is why maybe it is not favorable. But it all depends on the dignity of Jupiter. Okay, Jupiter is 8th lord and it is well placed, then also Jupiter can give good results. Best example is again Osho Rajneesh. He was a Taurus ascendant person. 8th house had 5 planets there, making him a complete mystic. And then 8th lord Jupiter is exalted in the 3rd house. So Jupiter was exalted. In the 3rd house. So although it was 8th lord, it was considered as a functional malefic for Taurus ascendant. But it was exalted. So he came out of all the controversies through his speech, through his courage, through his preachings. Okay. So because Jupiter was exalted in the 3rd house. So this is what it shows, that Jupiter is considered as a functional malefic. But in the end, it all depends on the dignity of the planet. Okay. In the end, it is all about the dignity of the planet. If the same Jupiter is debilitated in the 9th house, let's say the Taurus ascendant Jupiter rules the 8th house and it is debilitated in the 9th house Capricorn, then it shows that person is getting into conflicts and losing all his dignity and losing all his prestige and all that. Okay, losing everything because it is debilitated. Here, the person is getting into all the troubles and he is coming out of the troubles through his preaching and through his knowledge. That's why. So, in the end, it is all about dignity of the Jupiter rather than saying that Jupiter itself is not good for Taurus ascendant. Why is 8th house associated with money? You said we can use this house also for Dhani Yoga. Yes, 8th house is the most wealth-giving house. Second house is your wealth. 8th house is opposite to second house. It is the wealth of the other people. Wealth of everyone else in the world is in the 8th house. Second house is only your wealth. Everyone else's wealth is in the 8th house. Okay. That's why 8th house is also a house of taxes. Okay. Because taxes are wealth of other people. Then 8th house is also house of gambling, stock market, that is also wealth of other people. 8th house is also house of business benefits. If I am doing business, I can start my business in the 7th house, but how much I will gain from that business is from 8th house. Okay, that is that's why 8th house is the most wealth giving house. Because if at all someone becomes rich, it is only through business. It is only by dealing with other people, providing services to the other people and they pay you money. Okay, so that is why 8th house is the most wealth giving house. No other house can give you that much of wealth. 8th house is also like I think it is also house banks. Okay, so that is also 8th house is also like sustaining on other people money. Okay, like I was giving this example of Rajneesh Osho. He had 5 planets in the 8th house and his only source of money income was the charity coming from the other people. Other people paid him money and he lived his life on the that money. So that is the thing. So 8th house is the most wealth giving house. Someone has most planets exalted in D1 in other charts. Dignity is poor for those planets. Then which results is of more importance and vice versa. As I always say, D1 is the most important. D1 is the chart which is deciding the dignity. Okay, all other charts are coming out of your D1 chart. So even if you don't have a D1 chart, you cannot even think of making D9, D10 and all these charts. So we have to give the preference to the D1 chart. Okay, what's your take on debilitated planets having directional strength? How you will interpret it? For example, Saturn is debilitated but placed in the 7th house, where it gets the directional strength which will overrule. Dignity is always more important. Okay, dignity should be strong. If Saturn is debilitated in the 7th house, debilitation will overrule the directional strength, especially with the heavy planet like Saturn. Okay, so this person will have troublesome relationship life and they will be very fearful of starting their own business. They can be highly fearful that it would be their last option to start their own business when Saturn is in 7th house Aries. But let's take another example. If Sun is in the 10th house Libra, okay, the planet is debilitated but it is getting directional strength. This person in the beginning of his career, he will try to get into job setup. Okay, then he will not get any proper support from his authority figures, colleagues and all, and then he will think, okay, fine, if I should get into my own business, or if he gets counseling or something like that, then he may think about getting business. So eventually he will get into business and he will get the better authority through business. Okay, so in the job setup environment, this Saturn Sun will behave like a debilitated planet, but when he gets the gets into business setup, Libra business, then this Sun will bring the authority as Sun is getting the directional strength. Okay, so that's where the things can be beneficial. Let's take another example. Jupiter is debilitated in the first house. Jupiter and Mercury get directional strength in the first house. First house is the time of sunrise, and Jupiter and Mercury are education oriented planets. We go to school in the morning time, and that's why Jupiter and Mercury are getting directional strength in the first house. Now if Jupiter is debilitated in the Capricorn and in the first house, initially this person will not appreciate knowledge and education. Even if he gets the best teacher in the world, he will not appreciate this person. First of all, he may not get, but if he gets, he may not appreciate. This awareness of getting into knowledge or higher education or being wise will come with certain delay in life. So with other planets, things can improve with time. But as Saturn itself represents delays, okay, understand, Saturn itself in any case, even if Saturn is in exalted in Libra, even then Saturn is bringing better results when we cross over 35 mark. Here it is debilitated. So this is where like Saturn debilitated in Aries in the 7th house. It is like up to the 40 year mark, this person will be like very fearful of even thinking about getting into business. That is where the difficulty is coming. Can Saturn bring a dark skinned partner if in 7th house in Aquarius? We can say so. Saturn represents dark color. So they can attract a partner who is dark skinned. Okay. 8th is income from business or spirituality or both. 8th house can also be represented for spirituality because it is the house of occult. When you understand the occult side of life, okay, when I understand the astrology, okay, I am putting my effort here and there, but when Mars moves into this sign and when Saturn comes into that sign, I will get the result. Okay. If I understand this, then I understand that, okay, my efforts are not that important. Okay, they are important, but they are not everything. Someone else is running the show. He is making these planets moving here and there, and it is bringing the events. Okay. So when I understand the occult side of life, then I become more spiritual also. So 8th house can also be the house of spirituality through occult. People can understand spirituality or the higher power through the occult side of life. Dasha of debilitated planets. What about it? Dasha of debilitated planets can also be utilized well if awareness is there. If Mars is debilitated in Cancer, first of all, this person should become aware that he can have anger issues. He may have to take all the precautionary measures not to get into circumstances of accidents, sudden events, things like this. And this person should also have this awareness that he should not be aggressive towards others. If he has this awareness, if he has he is open to that much of counseling, then he can utilize the same Martian energy in Cancer in good ways, in benefic ways. Again, understand this, whenever a discussion of exalted and debilitated planets come, I always bring two examples. Exalted planets, Mark David Chapman. He had 4 exalted planets. He ended up in killing John Lennon. He became a murderer. 4 exalted planets. The debilitated planets, Helen Keller. Her ascendant lord was debilitated. Her ascendant nakshatra lord was debilitated. Okay. So, she had all the health issues to deal with throughout life. Still, she may manage to get the legend status in educational field. So, and this is what I am trying to say. It all depends upon the person, how he utilizes the energy of the planet. These planets are energies. This is what I always say. Your planetary chart, your astrological chart, your houses, planets, signs, nakshatras, they all represent energies. It depends upon you, how you utilize that energy. Okay. Understand this basic thing that 12th house represents spirituality. 12th house also represents sex. It depends upon the person where he is getting interested. Either he is getting interested in spirituality or he is getting interested in sex. It's his wish. This is where the free will is. You can choose among these options. And you will choose as per your evolution level. You will be interested in those things. This is why I say that this exaltation, debilitation or friendly sign, enemy sign, they matter, but they don't matter as much as what matters is the evolution level of the person who is going to utilize these planets. Okay. Like I say that if strong horses are arranged in your chariot, if you have a chariot which are which has very strong horses, now you also need a strong chariot driver. Otherwise, a weak chariot driver and these horses will take him here and there. So you may wish to have exalted planets, but then your evolution level should be of very high level to handle the energy of exalted planets. If you cannot handle, could not handle the energy of exalted planets, then these planets will take you here and there. This is what happened with Mark David Chapman. Exalted planets, four exalted planets. Okay, Sun exalted, Jupiter exalted, Venus exalted, Saturn exalted. These exalted planets gave him the feeling from the very beginning that he should be a famous person. He should be like a very known person. And to become a known person, he killed John Lennon. And that's what he said in the interview, that I was a nobody and I could not accept myself as a nobody. I wanted to be somebody. And the easiest way I found of becoming a somebody is to kill the biggest somebody of that time. So this is what I am saying, that we can desire all the exalted planets, but what they are giving is the high expectations from yourself, that you should be someone legend, you should be someone high up. What are you doing in this 9-to-5 job? Okay, so these type of feelings come when I have three exalted planets and I face that situation. So I know that. Okay, I have three exalted planets: Jupiter exalted, Moon exalted, Mars exalted. And I faced that till 7 years, 8 years back when I was working in corporate and all. I was thinking that what I am doing here. Okay, what I am doing, I am not supposed to be here. I am supposed to do something something which can make me known to the people. So this is what the exalted planets do. They set bars so high for you. And if someone is not able to understand this energy and not able to handle this energy, then they can go anywhere. They can take the wrong path also, like this guy took, Mark David Chapman. Okay. So this is what I am saying, I am always repeating, that these planets, these dignities, these houses, these nakshatras, they are all energies. It depends upon you, how you want to utilize the energy. That's it. Nakshatra for success in stock market. Purva Falguni, most important nakshatra. Purva Falguni, also Bharani, I guess. Dhanishta, okay. These nakshatra, there is an article for all these things. Means I have written article for different careers. If you want, you can go to the site and search for the article for the chart of person in financial nature of business, something like that. Then and you will find that article. There I have stated all the houses which are important, how all the signs which are important, all the nakshatras, all the planets. My Atma Karaka, Saturn, 7th Lord. Why husband were very fair? As I said, it can give a dark skinned person as a partner. I didn't say that it will only give dark skinned person as a partner. So it is just one of the possibility along with many other possibilities. Okay. So thank you. Thanks a lot for joining and asking questions. Nice session we had. Great. Thank you. Enjoy your Sunday. Let's meet next week. And I hope we can join a session in the evening again. I have consultations today, this is why I shifted to morning time. Otherwise, it could be in evening time only. Okay, thank you.